CK. It's nice to meet you. Can you tell me a bit about what you do and how you have contributed to society?
Sure. I've been in Singapore for almost 15 years. I came as a student, like many of you guys actually. And I run one of the largest IoT community in Southeast Asia. And I've been in touch with Campus Party SingX team for almost 1.5 years. So I've been supporting IoT development in the region. And when the team reached out to us, we decided that we have to support Campus Party because it's like something unique, like traditional conferences which we have been supporting a lot. But Campus Party was very unique in terms of the concept that's talking about not only just the ideas, but realization. And that's what we IoT SGs believes in. And we said, yes, we have to support it. Yeah.
So I just want to ask you, what is the best way to get like young people like me like involved in like what you do or like more interested in what you do?
I think we have to create a momentum. I think that's what Campus Party is, and that's what IoT SG is doing. We create a momentum continuously. We have to engage a lot. So while working in corporate for 15 years, we decided we have to engage with the students. I do teach actually also in universities. So we are pulling the audience from the institutes, from polytechnics. So it's more about like creating this momentum. There's less do something. So I think that's what Campus Party is, that I see there's a Facebook page actually also that's Campus Party doesn't stop on 8th actually, it's like start from there. So that's how you engage the students like yourself.
Okay, thank you. So I just have one more question for you. Let me think about it. Suddenly forgot. What is the activity so far that you have enjoyed the most at Campus Party?
I think what I like most basically that in table conferences you hear the ideas and creativity from one location, like, but we have here people from Nepal, from Bhutan, from Thailand, from Sri Lanka, from all over the place. And that's what I like actually, that it opens up our mind that Singapore is not only about Singapore, it's more about inclusion of the rest of the world. So that's what actually I liked the most in this event, the collaborating with a lot of other people from different regions. And I hope we get a chance to do more often of this.
So lastly, what advice do you have for young people in general?
The advice for the young people is that technology is changing a lot, way much faster than in my time. So you have to go out more often. The age of gig economy is already there. At the same time, you have to like continuously be ready for the future. So learn as much as you can. For me, like I read every day a lot. So read a lot, meet more people, and learn as much as you can, because what you learn in your degree is not enough. You learn a lot more when you talk to other people. Yeah.
Can you tell me about one book which really inspired you?
One book actually I personally like and which I recommend to a lot of professionals also is called The Goal. It's from an Israeli professor, Dr. Goldratt. And The Goal is like a very simple novel actually, but it tells you so much insights. How do we look at the problems and how do we identify the problems and work towards it? So I always recommend the book called The Goal.
Yeah. Okay, so thank you so much for answering all my questions.